Hey folks, welcome to another Triple T Thursday. For those just joining us, that's tools, tips, and talk, where we'll discuss info for the knife maker. In today's episode, I'm excited to show you guys a new build. But this time, we're going to be building a tool. So, we're going to turn some steel into this. Yep, we're going to be building a Damascus twisting machine. So, generally, these can be really pricey, up into the thousands. We're going to build this one for $250. Let's go take a look.
If you're looking for steel to make Damascus out of, tools, or anything in between, check out our sponsor, Maritime Knife Supply. They have everything you need. You can even shop and pay in U.S. dollars.
So here are all the things you're going to need. So first off, I went to Harbor Freight and got one of these right-angled drills. These are pretty beefy, and they have a lot of torque and a lot of power. This thing cost me $170, $169.99 at Harbor Freight. You can just use it as is. You'll notice on this one, the Bauer, it has a hole on the left and the right for a handle, but this is how we're going to mount it. So very useful to have them on both sides. The twister is going to be sitting on a rail. So this is just a piece of 2-inch square tube. I wanted it pretty rigid, so I got 1/4-inch square tube. I got a 3-foot piece of this, but the only things that I bought, besides the drill, was the steel pipe. Okay, this one, and then a piece, just I got literally a 1-foot piece of this pipe. This is a seamless 2.5-inch pipe that will slide over top of this, and you'll see why that's important. Then the only thing I fabricated was I just made a little holder. You can see there's a hole here and here, and that's where the two bolts, the only other two things that I bought, will go in here and just center the drill. Okay, so the drill will kind of hang down, and then this tube will fit over that. And you'll see when I put it on the anvil. When I say anvil, I actually put a piece here that I can just sit this in my hardy hole on the anvil, because then it's right beside my forge, it doesn't go anywhere, and it's super solid. So this was just welding up some scrap steel that I had. If you don't have this, okay, buy a, you know, I use 3/8, which is probably overkill. You could easily done this with 3/16 or 1/4-inch. Next, so that's kind of the headstock where this is going to be. The next thing you need to do is build just little collets, I guess you could call them. And these are just things that will fit in the drill. I just hexed off a piece of half-inch stock here, and then I just built a little square tube here in a couple of different sizes. I've got one here that's 3/4, this one's 1-inch, and I'll probably make one that's 5/8. And that's really all you'll need. I mean, you're not really going to twist too many different thicknesses. And I've got kiss blocks for my press, so I can press it exactly to this. So you want to get your billet all set up to just slide in here. Okay, the tailstock, okay, the other end that's going to fit in. I went a little overboard on this. At first I bought, this is the interior, this is a pipe clamp. I bought one at Harbor Freight. They were $6.99 for this pipe. It ended up snapping off the handle, you know, cheap Harbor Freight stuff. So the only thing that it's doing is I have those little pieces there that slide on that rail, but I'm not really using it for its purpose, so I probably could have just machined this anyway, because what I ended up doing is welding this C-clamp on here, just so that I could easily change the thickness. Could I go with a collet like this at the other end? Absolutely. If I was to do this again, I probably would have had these just slide into something, because this is going to slide on this pipe. So you could have just slid this into a little holder and then pushed this in and met the two ends. It probably would have been a lot easier. So anyway, I have it adjustable as it is. So I'll put this all together. I'll put it on the anvil, and we'll give you guys a demo of what this does. Okay, let's talk about the operation. So I've put the collet in here. This will slide back and forth. Normally you would start with this out here. This would be your hot piece of steel. You would take it out of the forge, slide it in there, slide this up. Obviously you're not going to be holding it with your hand. Put that in there. I'm not going to hit the power button right now because this is cold, but I'll just leave that in there. I've got this set up. I've got the trigger just zip tied because I have it plugged into a foot pedal. It just means I don't have to bend over and hit the trigger down here. So I'm just, okay, you can see it's got some power, so you don't want to be holding on to that. You take that out. So, and you can just feather the foot switch here the first couple of times you do it. This thing will rotate, I think it says 450 RPMs, but just touching the foot pedal a couple of times will give you most of the rotation that you need. It has a lot of power. It also, the nice thing is, has a very simple reverse switch. So when you're doing Turkish twists, you want to twist one way and twist one the other way. So the reverse switch is very handy. These things also have a low and a high. That's what this dial down here is. You want to make sure it's on low, because when this is on high, I think it's 1200 RPM. So obviously you don't want it running that fast. That's all there is to it. You just put this in. It's a very simple build. Put it in here. You need to get the steel quite hot, like white hot. Then put it in here and try to be as fast as you can to get it in here and then get it spinning. The nice thing about this, it's got speed. Okay, some of the pipe threaders, while they have a lot of torque, they don't have a lot of speed. So it actually takes you a couple of heats to get them twisted enough. This one you can do it in one heat, and this thing will actually kick off. So that you'll hear it, it'll start to click if it doesn't have enough power, which is nice because that means your billet is too cool. This thing's not twisting it. With a pipe threader, you can actually shear your billet apart because it has so much torque. Whereas this one has speed, but not quite as much torque, not near as much torque, which is kind of good because this thing will click, the clutch will disengage. And it'll stop twisting if the billet gets too cool. That's much better than ripping your billet apart. Okay, I'll show you guys a video of this in action. It took me a couple of tries to, get it figured out. I had to screw with this a little bit, but now that I have this kind of reconfigured and dialed in, it works really great. So take a look.
Sorry about the video quality here, folks. I had my camera in 1080 instead of 4K. Here I'm using this spray bottle just to cool down a section so it doesn't twist as much. I got a tip from a buddy, Rick Hall, who actually gave me this design, to use compressed air. Works a little better. So I've got this one twisted about where I want it. Now I just got to take it out of the rig. All done. As simple as that.
So obviously I could cut this pipe down. I'm probably not going to do twists longer than this, but it's just right now it's just sitting on the horn here, and I just have this propped up a little bit so that this part slides free. The reason you need this part to slide free is as you twist, it's actually going to pull this in a little bit. So this part has to slide and has to be free. It doesn't matter, there's a little play in this, and you'll notice this is not even, it's just slid in there. All of the stresses on this are torque going this way. So as long as these are rigid, the bolts are there, you can see this thing even swings this way. But all of the torque goes this way. It's all rotational, like torque is. It's a great design. This is actually a design that came from my buddy Rick Hall. It was his idea, but he got it from Michael Quisenberry. And if you don't know who Michael is, he is a master smith who specializes. One of his specialties is amazing Texas twist patterns. And this is what he uses. So thanks, Rick and Mike, for the idea on this twisting machine. Hopefully this helps you guys out. Thanks for watching, folks. We'll see you on the next one.